Welcome back, student. I am Surma Ghosh, the accountancy teacher of PU from Burdwan Model School. Dear student, very good morning. Today we also start from where we ends in our last class, that is non-profit organization. Today we learn the adjustment entry. How can we do the adjustment entry in NPO accounting? Okay, we already done the final account in your 11th class. Okay, in your 11th class, what have you done? You done the trading and profit and loss account and balance sheet. This is your final account actually. Okay, here you also done the same thing, just name is changed, work is same. Okay, so there is in trading and profit and loss accounts, their substitute is income and expenditure account, and balance sheet there is also do the balance sheet also. So what type of adjustment come in NPO? We have already done some adjustment in our 11th class in commercial final account. Okay, in commercial final account, what we see? We see the there is prepaid expenses, outstanding expenses, there is a depreciation. Here also do the same thing, but in commercial organization, there is a we actually sell the goods. Here we do not sell the goods. So sale related adjustment that like debtors. If there is no debtors, here we do, if there is no debtors, so we cannot do the bad debt or related provision for bad debt or provision for that doubtful debt. This type of adjustment we cannot do or do not need to do in here. Okay, so what main three adjustment we will do in here? What are these? Outstanding expenses or outstanding income, or prepaid expense or prepaid income, and some depreciation, and some consumable goods or stock related adjustment we will do here. So how can, though there is only three adjustment in there, but the number of adjustment will be more. Why the number of adjustment will be more? Because here we actually start our accounts from receive and payment account. We have to, in your examination or in your book, you can see there is a receive and payment account from your accounts is start, not from the trial balance. In receive and payment account, we start the accounts, there is some problem. What is the problem and why is this adjustment is more? Though this is a quantity, the variety is less in NPO, but quantity of adjustment will be more. Why? That's I will show. Let assume we will start a charitable organization. So we start a charitable organization. What will do? We will do a receive and payment account.
Sorry, this is 2009, this is 2020.
Suppose we start a charitable organization in 2019, so we do the receive and payment account 2019, and receive and payment account. In receive and payment account, in our last class, we have seen there is a left side, there is a receive, that means when the cash is come, there is a receipt, this is rupees, and there is a payment in your right side. That means you spend some money. Okay. When the cash is flow out from your business, when the cash is come to your business, this is a receipt. When the cash is flow out or spend some money, this is a payment. So this is a new organization. We are just starting the organization, so we need some capital. Let assume some of the 10 or 12 members in this organization give some cash to this organization, and this is called the capital fund. to capital fund. Suppose this is 1 lakh rupees. That you have already seen in your last class, there are other income also. Suppose somebody give us the donation. So, this is also the incoming of cash. So, we will write down in receipt side to donation, say 50,000. Now, we can collect subscription also, to subscription. Say this is also 50,000. So, this is the total income. What is that? 2 lakh rupees. Now, we have to spend some money. In charitable fund also, we have to, there is expense or spend some money. For what? As this is very new, so you have to buy, you should have an office. From there you can maintain or control the accounting work or other financial work or other social purpose work of the organization. And that's for you have to buy to help of the, suppose help of the local government in concession, you have to buy some land and building. So, we have to purchase a land and building. Land and building. Suppose this is 90,000. There should be other asset we also need. There should be some furniture. Suppose we spend on furniture rupees 10,000. In nowadays, computer is common in all the organizations. So, you spend some amount for buy purchase of computer. Computer, and suppose computer is 40,000. So, already spend 1,60,000. Sorry, 1,40,000 in our purchasing of asset. So, 60,000 is still left. So, we will start the charity work. Let we spend some money for charity. Say 50,000. Okay, 50,000. Right. By charity, we will do the spend some money for 50,000. And there are still 10,000 is left. And what is that? This is by balance CD. Means your cash balance, okay, cash in hand. In current year, the same way we will do the receive and payment account. Receive and payment account for 2020. This is received. When there is a receipt or money comes, we will plus rupees. This is a payment. This is rupees. And we will spend some money, we will minus it. Okay. So, this time, this is a second year. So, this time we do not need a capital fund because we already have a cash balance in previous year. So, we have to transfer this cash balance to this year, to balance BD, 10,000. Here also, again, we will receive some income and spend some money, okay. We will receive some income and spend some money, and that is why working is going on of our charitable institution or charitable organization. So here also it received some donation, two subscription. And we can receive also the some grant also, okay, two grant. So all are the, let's say 50,000, 50,000 and 50,000, total 1,60,000. Now as we already collected some managed asset or spend some money to purchase asset for management, we have already done for this part, but still somebody says we need some asset more. What for? Because in charitable organization we have to make aware of the people or public. For that there is a problem of to reach to or from your end to reach to there. So there is a need of a, they feel there is a need of a vehicle. So this time we will purchase a vehicle, okay. So buy vehicle. So this, let's say this amount is 50,000 and rest of the money we will spend for the charity purpose. So charity, suppose this is 1 lakh, still that is money left, and that is the buy balance CD 10,000. Though the both of the CD is 10,000, it is not necessary for every time this amount will be the same. Here for our calculation it is revealed both are same, but it is not necessary both amount is same, okay. So actually I would like to make you understand what for we make these two accounts. One is 2019 receivable payment account and one is 2020 receivable payment account. Look, there how many assets is there. Look, this is a one asset, this is a vehicle in this year, and previous year there is a three asset, 1, 2 and 3, land and building 90,000, furniture 10,000 and computer 40,000. If you ask to how many asset in your charitable organization now, so your answer will be land and building, furniture, computer and vehicle also. So you can clearly see in here how many asset in your organization is there. But if I erase this account, this receivable and payment account, if I erase from your sight, then what will happen? Now I will ask you how many asset in your organization. Is it seen to you? No, only the vehicle is showing to you, because this is our current year receivable payment account. So our current year receivable payment account, which is actually given to your book or your examination, this is a current year receivable payment account. You see there is a 2 balance BD and buy balance CD, not the previous year receivable payment account. So how will know the there is how many asset in there? Because here we are doing, though the actual reality, in reality there is a 4 asset in our charitable organization. One is land and building, one is furniture and one is computer, okay. But that cannot be seen in your receive and payment account in your current year. Have you seen that? No. So how can you know how many asset? These asset you cannot eliminate because these are the all are the long lasting asset. You can get economic benefit from this asset from long time. So you cannot erase this asset from the next year. So it is actual reality in your organization. This asset has already in your organization. Okay. So you just charge some depreciation or make some depreciation on this asset also. So this asset is not come to this our current year receive and payment account. Then how will know the asset will be there? This because if we do the from receive and payment account, this is a problem of receive and payment account. If we will do the things, if we start our accounts from trial balance or from trial balance we make the our final account, actually we have done in our commercial organization. Here we have done our start from our receive and payment account. We start our accounting from receive and payment account, not from trial balance. In commercial organization, our final account we actually taken from our trial balance, not from receive and payment account and all those things. Okay. So if you your accounting will begin from your trial balance, you can easily get this type of this asset you can find in your trial balance. This land and building, furniture, and there is no need of extra adjustment for that. So in there definitely they should tell you what is the land and building value, what is the furniture value, what is the computer value. So these are the adjustment will be, number of adjustment will be increased because they have to set that what is the land and building value, what is the furniture value, otherwise you cannot or you would not know what actually the previous year asset is there. And if there is some maybe some liability also, okay, the previous year liability also in there, and you have to come to this asset where we are entry, where we posted this asset. This asset is posted in your balance sheet. If this is a previous year asset, so where we will put in your previous year, means in opening you have to make, in this case in NPO we have to make two balance sheet. One is opening balance sheet, and as you know this is a card, if one is closing balance sheet. Closing balance sheet means current year balance sheet, which we have already done in your 11th class, trading and account, profit and loss account and balance sheet. But here you have to do the income and expenditure account and opening balance sheet also. Okay. Otherwise you cannot understand, you cannot do the your adjustment. So this land and building furniture, if your adjustment is given or additional information is given, there you have to put this furniture, computer, land and building or any type of other liabilities may be there, you have to put. So there this is the increase of the your adjustment, increase the number of adjustment, not variety of adjustment, number of adjustment will be more in here. Now the question is arise, if there is number of adjustment is more, this is difficult for you or this is easy for you? Though the number of adjustment in here is more, but these are not the very complicated, because earlier as you said there is mainly three type of adjustment is there. One is outstanding, but there is outstanding, there is two type of outstanding, not one, not only one outstanding. This is the last current year outstanding and also the last year outstanding. Okay, there is two outstanding always. Advance, there is some advance also, and same thing, advance is also the last year advance and current year advance and some depreciation. We already see some asset. In previous year asset, we also make some depreciation. These three type of adjustment mainly in there. Okay. There is no manager's commission, because in our charitable organization, there is no manager. We are all work for voluntary, and for that we are getting some remuneration will be paid to them, or we will get some remuneration, not the manager's commission or the debtors related adjustment or provision related adjustment will not done. This is in will not done in here. So, this is the end of the this adjustment. Only advance, outstanding and some consumable goods item will also come, means some medicine, opening stock, closing stock, some food items adjustment we have to make, and some depreciation will be there. Okay, so how can we work out the our adjustment? Now let's see how we'll do the adjustment entry very easily. So your time will be less than what you have done before in your final account adjustment. Okay. So now I'll make a statement. Sorry. We'll first show the any income. What would be our adjustment? For any income, how can we do the our adjustment? Any income. And we also know if there is any adjustment, the effect of in two places, or we have to post it in two places, either in income or expenditure account or in balance sheet. We have done it in your 11th class. If any additional information or adjustment in there, we have to post it in two places, not just one place. We have to post it in, effect should be shown in two places. Okay. Here is also the effect will be come in two places. Okay. One is income and expenditure account and one is balance sheet. Now, first any income from where we will get the income. So, income receipts from debit side from receive and payment account. In debit side of receive and payment account, you have income. You can take your income from debit side of receive and payment account, and you posted suppose subscription, and this subscription you posted in credit side of your income and expenditure by subscription. You already learned these things in our last class also. Okay, we already learned. So here we are posting it in income and expenditure account. Will it come in balance sheet? No. This is not actually an adjustment. This is just a posting of subscription, which actually is shown in your receive and payment account, which had already shown in your receive and payment account. This is not your adjustment. Okay, so this is just a posting, and posted in inner side, because there may be some adjustment also. Okay. So, in case of income, we have already told there is two things in there. Maybe our income is more means we receive some advance income, or it will be the less. If we receive some less income, what does it mean? This means due of income, that means outstanding of income. So, two things will be happen. One is advance. If we receive income of somebody's or some students, maybe some members, subscription you receive in more, then it will call the advance receive. If we receive the less, that means this is due to us, and this is the call we this will call the outstanding. So, two things will happen, one is outstanding, one is advance. But there we have already told in few times before, there is two outstanding and two advance. What is two outstanding and two advance? One outstanding may be last year, and one outstanding for the current year. One advance for the last year and one advance for the current year. So, if we write outstanding for the current year and outstanding for the last year. In same way, we can write down advance for the current year and advance for the last year. Okay. Outstanding for the current year, there will may be outstanding for the current year means this year, this is year of 2020, and outstanding for the last year, this means for 2019, end of the outstanding at the end of last year, at the end of last year, advance for the current year, advance for the end of last year. Means this year, starting of this year, and outstanding of the end of current year, end of current year, this is also end of current year. Because in the middle time, there is no outstanding or advance will be happen. Okay. This outstanding for the end of current year, outstanding for the end of last year. Always these are happen in end. Okay. Advance for the end of end of current year and end of advance for the end of last year means your previous year. Okay. So, how will do the adjustment? These four things. For that, here we will for make you understand, we will draw a diagram. Okay. Suppose somebody gives you to refill, what will be the outstanding and advance amount of this year, which will be in your subscription. If the subscription they give you in your question, maybe they give you the total, what would be the adjustment for subscription if these are given. Suppose we will take 2020 in our current year. If this 2020 in our current year, so we will reveal our subscription for the year 2020. because this is our current year. Anything belonging to 2020 will plus it, okay, we will plus it. Anything belonging to 2020 will plus it, and we can write 2019 as a previous year and 2021 as a next year. So, this is the previous year and this is the next year, and we can say this is we know these are our current year. So, here we cannot reveal or we cannot do the account for or make adjustment for this 3 year total. Only we will do the related or which is belonging to the 2020 means current year. We cannot do the accounts of 2019 and 2020 in the same way, okay, because now we will do the accounts for 2020 only. So, anything belonging to 2020 will be the plus, and anything is previous year will be minus, and anything is 2020 next year is minus also. That's not means we will not account for 2019 and all the 2019 will be the minus. For related to the 2020, 2019, if there is anything 2019, this will be the minus. If anything 2021, this is the minus. But if this is a 2021 is your current year, then this is a, if you belonging to 2021 any adjustment, then it will be the plus in here also. There's maybe 2022, 2023 will be your current year. Now our current year is 2020, and we will do all the adjustment related to 2020. And if anything belonging to 2020, we will add it to this account, okay. How can we do? Suppose here we can see in our adjustment outstanding for the end of current year. This is the outstanding for the end of current year means end of current year 2020, end of current year, and end of last year means beginning of this year. Okay, similarly advance in your last year or advance for your current year, okay. So, how we will treat this outstanding and advance of last year and current year, mainly we will do that, okay. In 2020, we just minutely see that anything belonging to the 2020, we only add those things and all other things will be the minus. Suppose in advance, if we ask you, if I ask you to give me the fees advance for your school fees for the next year, then what is means? It means advance is always for future. It runs towards the future. If you advance some fees for your school now, means is for the future. So, advance of the last year runs towards the future in this way. So, in which June it will fall? It is fall in 2020, and advance of the current year means this year advance, what for will give? We give for the next year. So, this will be run towards the next year for 2021. And here you can clearly see if anything not belonging to the 2020, it will be the minus. So, it will be the minus for the current year advance, and your last year advance, this will be the plus, because this is fall under 2020 region, okay. This is the fall under 2020 region. In same way, outstanding. Outstanding means if I ask you, if still you have not paid your due still debt for of your school fees, that means what does it mean? It means this actually indicate your backward fees. okay, your backward period is still not given or is still due, and this is outstanding. Okay, you have to pay it, but you did not pay the fees. So this is your due amount, and this due amount for your past. So this is always outstanding, always refers to the past. Okay, so if any outstanding in your last year, this is means it runs toward your last year. This should be runs toward in your last year, and current year outstanding means this is the related to this year outstanding. Okay, this year, this is related to your this year outstanding. This is, have you understood? Again, you say if anything you are outstanding or anything you do, this is always related to your past. And in past, so which way this will be run? The run will be the your past. What is your past? Last year, beginning of this year means end of the last year. Outstanding will be runs toward your past year. And this current year outstanding will be also runs toward your backward way, means past way. If you will so this outstanding in which region? If this is a current region, so that should be the plus, and this outstanding will be the previous year, so that should be the minus. Have you understood? This is a very clear picture you can get, and if you remember this, you have to make the adjustment in the 1 or 2 minutes. How many adjustment or how many number of adjustment in your examination, you can do it in 1 or 2 minutes. That's why I have said, though these are number of adjustment is more, but your time is less, because these are not the very complicated. In your final account in 11th class, the adjustment is, as the adjustment have been very complicated also. So you have so you need more time, but here you can see that though the number of adjustment will be more or number increase will be more, but your time will be less. You just remember these things. Okay, now you can put outstanding for the end of current year. Outstanding for the end of current year, this will be the plus. Outstanding for the end of last year, this will be the minus. So we will box in here because this is outstanding. In case of advance, the advance for the end of current year, advance for the end of current year, that will be the end of current year, that means that will be the minus, and advance for the end of last year, that will be the plus. Okay, now you can understand. Outstanding for the end of last year, end of last year means end of 2019, that is the minus, because this is not belonging to the year 2020. Outstanding for the end of current year means end of 2020. It is related to 2000, belonging to 2020, that's why this is at or plus. Same way, advance, the last year advance will be the plus as it belonging to 2020, and current year advance will be the minus as it belonging to the next year, not this year. Okay, we payment our advance for the next year, not for this year. Okay, so this chart you should remember or note down. It will be very easy for you to make adjustment of outstanding or advance of any income. In case of, now you look, this is a half done. Because we know our adjustment has effect of two places. If we posting in one, the other entry would be posted somewhere else in their balance sheet also. This is for income and expenditure account, and the other effect will be come to our balance sheet. In balance sheet, where we should post. Now look. If I say your fees is still due, your income is still due or your outstanding, okay. Your income is still outstanding means you will receive or you will receive some cash in future. Where from we receive cash in future? This is our assets, okay. So, all the outstanding, though it is the end of the year or is the last year, end of the current year or end of the last year, both will be the asset. In asset side of balance sheet, we will post. Okay. If advance somebody paid me or collect in advance income, so we have some responsibility for them, and therefore maybe we not expense in last year. So this is our liability. If we receive some advance income, so this is our responsibility also. That is from there. This is our liability. Okay, so advance income is with the liability. Have you understood? So, it may be the current year period, it may be the last year period. You just post in current year balance sheet, outstanding for the end of current year. End of current year means your current year balance sheet will come to your current year balance sheet and it will come to your last year balance sheet. But both are the asset in at case of advance. In case of advance, this is also come to your current year. End of current year balance sheet, in timing is concerned, and it's your last year balance sheet. So both are come to the balance sheet, though the period is changed. Okay, and if the last year outstanding, this is also asset, and current year outstanding is also asset. Last year advance also liabilities, and current year advance is also a liabilities. Okay. Have you understood these things, how you posted in your balance sheet also? Okay. So now there is another adjustment is there. What is that adjustment? Another adjustment is there is sometimes you consume some goods. What type of goods? Maybe you some purchase some food, and you consume foods or purchase some medicine or purchase some stationery. These are called consumable goods. In NPO, there is some consumable goods also we have consumed. And reality, this is actually the expenses. In reality, these are the expenses. So, now come to the point of expenses. If there is any expenses, what will happen? Any expenses. So, payment of expenses, this is carry side, any expenses, that's your salary, wages, electricity bill, rent paid, okay, these are the expenses. This come to your receive and payment account, you can see in your carry side. So, receive and payment account, this is a carry side, but here you will, when the income and expenditure account, that will be your debit side. To salary, maybe there is some adjustment, that's why I have written down in your inner column, okay. In here also, so we have to posted in here, income and expenditure account, but in your debit side. Okay, and balance sheet, this is not effect, because this is just a posting of the expenses. Okay, posting of the expenses. And there is also, in case of expenses, we made some advance expense, prepaid expenses, we can pay prepaid salary for somebody, or we can pay prepaid rent to somebody. Okay, in outstanding also, maybe we cannot pay 1 month salary, and that should be the outstanding or due amount. Okay. So, in a case of expense, there is also a outstanding and advance expenses or outstanding expenses. Okay. But the whole process, if this is a expenses, if outstanding expenses is there, in last year outstanding expenses, here you can see the whole diagram, last year outstanding expenses, this will be the same thing. This will be the not related to your current year expenses. So, this will be the minus or deduct. And last year in current year expenses, this will be the added. And same thing the advance. If you paid some advance money to somebody, okay, then you will, if advance money will pay to somebody for last current year, that means this is for the next year. And in last year, the same. So, there is no change for 1% of this adjustment in case of expenses. All things are changed, but only thing is changed, the side will be changed. And before, this is a carry side where adjustment will be made, all the add and minus should be in carry side. Now, we will do the add and minus will be the debit side in case of expenses. So, suppose in our exam, in our problem set, the outstanding salary of the last year, outstanding salary of the last year will be the 10,000. So, will be minus from there. And outstanding subscription of the last year 10,000. So, will be minus from there. So, adjustment will be the same. So, only side is changing. Only side is changing. Okay. But in the case of balance sheet, in the case of balance sheet, this also side will be the change. Outstanding expenses. If you expenses, outstanding expenses means due expenses. You still have to make your expenses, which is not still you have made. So, this is your liability. Okay. So, in case of expenses, this will be your liability. In case of advance, if you paid somebody's rent in advance, that means this is from there you will make some 2 minute economic benefit. Okay, assets. So you have already looked what is the adjustment procedure, expenses, any expenses or any income. It may be salary, it may be wages. Or in case of income, it may be subscription, okay, it may be donation, what will be the thing you have to make in this way. Hope you will understand and enjoy the classes for today. This is will be the end of the session. Thank you for watching. Stay home, stay safe.
আজকে তাড়াতাড়ি হয়ে গেল মনে হচ্ছে
তাড়াতাড়ি আমাদেরকে ওখান থেকে ইয়ে করা আছে 45